My name is Wang Zhi Cui. I'm a group leader, and they are my group member.
My name is Gan Wei Song.
My name is Gan Cheng Ling.
And my name is Song Yu Yang.
Yeah, so this is the title of our term paper, Eradication of Poverty. So our term paper consists of five different parts, which is introduction, factor that leads to poverty, negative effect of poverty towards individuals, solution of poverty, and the conclusion. So next, I would like to invite Cheng Ling to present the introduction of the paper.
Present the introduction of our term paper. Poverty is an international concern. UK Essay 2017 proposed that although every country in the world faces the poverty problems, there are still some countries in Asia, Africa, and Latin America poorer than the others. Kuma 2018 proposed that there are six different types of poverty, which are absolute poverty, relative poverty, situational poverty, generational poverty, rural poverty, and urban poverty. Absolute poverty is not common in developed countries as it involves the shortage of basic needs of humans, such as situational poverty is poverty which is temporary as the happening of an unfavorable event. Generational poverty is poverty that are passed through from generation to generation. Rural poverty is poverty occurred in rural areas with lesser population. Conversely, urban poverty is poverty which is occurring in urban areas with a larger population. The thesis statement of this term paper is: the paper aims to discuss the factors that contribute to poverty and the effects to the world populations. Finally, the paper would suggest ways that every country can implement to ensure its populations can live in prosperity. Now we are going to invite...
Now I want to introduce about the factor that leads to the poverty. The first factor is the inequality and discrimination. And poverty and inequality are different, but inequality contributes to extensive poverty by preventing access to tools and resources by groups with lower social status. The world has a lot of the different kinds of the inequality, ranging from economy to social inequality like class system, gender, and tribal affiliation. However, irrespective of the inequalities, it usually means the same thing: unequal, not access to the resource needed to keep a family of poverty. Okay. Discrimination, racism, and prejudice together constitute the main cause of the poverty. Thus, who are discriminated against often do not have the same opportunity and benefit the rest of the country. The second factor is the lack of the education and infrastructure. Literacy and lack of the education travel in needy countries. Government in developing countries are not able to provide public school, and especially in the countryside. Children have access to education in nearly all industrial countries, but in sub-Saharan Africa, only about 60% of children can attend primary school. The poor students also often give up study to concentrate on creating a minimum of life. However, employment opportunity in developing countries tend to be small, especially for women. Unemployment is just a few percentage point of in a popular country, which means millions of the working age people could not find a job and earn enough. Since the unemployment data only indicate the number of the people who are not working but are looking for work, but the statistics may not make everyone friends young to continue about the
effects. And hi, I'm Song Yu Yang, and now I would like to explain on the negative effects of poverty towards the individual. There may be two effects. The first one is negative impact of the physical health of children, and the second one is the poor genetic progress by children. So, about the first point, the negative impact on the physical health of children. The children from the poor family tend to be weaker since they have insufficient intake of vitamins and essential nutrition for the growth of body. Since the poor family have insufficient money to buy the enough food for the children's needs, and this has led to this is the main reason that the poverty will bring negative impacts to the children. So according to the Pohemers and Essentia, 6% of children qualify of federal nutritional assistance from birth to age 4 years was short stature compared with 3.7% of all US children of the same age. The data have shown that the effects of poverty to growth and development of children prove that the poverty bring negative effects to the physical health of children. The next point is the poor academic progress by the children. So the poor family the academic resources that can be provided to the children by a poor family is very limited. This has caused the children to have a serious attention. 2018, the data from the 2013 reveals that 89% of fourth grade students from low-income families reach below the proficiency level, compared with 49% of students from higher-income families. So the data has proved that the poverty did bring a negative impact to the academic progress by children. And next, I would like to pass to my friend Zhi Cui to expand on the solution.
So I'm going to describe the solution to eradicate poverty. So there are many types of solutions to eradicate the poverty. So first is the education, microfinance, role of media. How does education can eradicate poverty? So people who live in poverty are very hard to attend a formal education, and this situation will make them more difficult to escape from their current living and working condition. So most of the country provide free education for their pupils. However, for the children who live in rural areas, may have to travel a long journey to get to school, and this might aggravate the burden of low-income families. So therefore, some of them who are unable to afford the education fees of their children are compelled to ask their children to quit school and get to work to support their daily expenses. And this situation is often happens because government do not pay much attention for the education in rural areas. So as you can see, according to Nihan Taitan and Yana 2015, education is an essential investment as it could eradicate 12% of poor poverty if students left the school with basic skill of education, increase the likelihood that men and women will not be employed. As you can see, education can provide more secure jobs and good working conditions and also decent pay. So we can conclude that poverty and microfinance. What is microfinance? Microfinance will provide a loan, saving and other basic financial service to the poor. And according to Kaiba 2019, a promising way to eradicate poverty is through microfinance. And microfinance is like a chance for the poor population to access to financial services. According to a report from advocacy organization, Microcredit Summit Campaign by 2013, some 3,098 microfinance institutions had reached over 211 million clients worldwide, just under half of whom were living in extreme poverty. So, microfinance gives poor people an opportunity to become an entrepreneur, and this might able to increase their earning and improve their life qualities. A lot of leaders offer their small and financial service to improve their clients' odds of building a successful small business. For example, in 1970s, Bangladesh established microfinance sector to reduce poverty in rural areas by giving a small loan for non-group activities. Now, the microfinance institution NIF in Bangladesh has over 32 million members and gives out more than 7.2 billion per year. So, this shows that microfinance is through media. This is because media has the power to influence the global consciousness and property issue. As you can see, in developing public understanding of economic, social, and environmental issues, the media plays a vital role. The media are at a crossroad between potential tools and innovations that can be used for the sustainable future. According to Wood 2017, reduction of poverty has raised a particular agenda, making it much more newsworthy for journalists and providing significant opportunity for those who want to engage with the media. Media have to publicize poverty by seeing where and how government choose to spend taxpayer money in all income to help countries. Exploiting natural resources has higher priority over which government makes country with plenty natural resources. Competing oil and mining companies supported by their government have frequently been ready to deal with anyone who guarantee them of conscious concessions, and this might lead to corruption. So, through media, the media and public have to see the details of government, like how they spend the money of taxpayer and its income, its own income. And this will make government responsible for their actually. The last way to eradicate poverty is to improve the agricultural program. So there are many proof that agriculture can reduce poverty more than poses a direct effect on farmers' income. As you can see, the development in the agriculture can encourage economic development other than the agricultural sector and increase the job opportunities. And increased agriculture productivity increases the farm's earning, raising food supply, lower food costing, and provide more job opportunity in both rural and urban areas. Since 1978, China has been helping 800 people out of destitution. According to Baringo 2017, as a part of its 2020 poverty eradication tactic, China's Agriculture Bank will allocate above 400 billion to support countryside development, funding education, infrastructure, and crop production. And however, the challenge we face in solving this problem is to continue play the role in external development assistance. And this is ethically compelling, but also as a remuneration for the costs imposed on poor country by rich country. So, that's my point. Next, I would like to pass back to our third paper.
Poverty is a global problem. It is the first goal in the Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs, set by United Nations. According to SAPENA 2018, poverty eradication has been identified again and again as the biggest challenge facing by global societies in his desire for a peace, prosperous world. Factors linked to poverty need to be identified first, and solutions are needed to eradicate poverty, as poverty brings many negative effects to the world. Actions speak louder than words. Every global citizen should work hand in hand, shoulder to shoulder, to eradicate poverty in all forms, so that we can live in peace and prosperity. That's all for our presentation. Thank you.